All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, Kodash. Double honors to apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well. And peace and blessings to the elect Akim and one third out there pushing this word in truth and sincerity. You know, right now it's spring break. St. Patrick's Day is coming up, March Madness, and you know, it's a whole lot of folly going on. Alright, so this is what has inspired this lesson. Alright, this is Matthew 24, verse 37. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. Alright? So they're eating and drinking, you know, they're having a jolly good old time, alright? You know, feasting, drinking a whole bunch of alcohol, like you see these college kids and high school kids on spring break down at the beaches, or at the ski lodges, and you know, that's what's going on now, man. Marrying and giving in marriage, right? And you know, according to the Bible, marriage is sex, right? So when you see like all these spring breakers going out, you know, they literally pass out condoms like by a shit ton for free, you know, to prevent STDs going around. Yeah, man. Verse 39, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Alright, so while they're in the midst of having their little bit of fun at that time, the flood came, you know, and in the midst of them, you know, being happy and jolly, alright, because they weren't listening to Noah, alright. I'm going to jump to, let's see, Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, alright? So the point being that fourth verse, alright? You know, there's a time to weep and a time to laugh. Alright, now's not the time to be laughing and dancing. Now's the time for weeping and mourning, alright? You know, you're supposed to sigh and cry for the abominations that are done in the earth, you know? Because, you know, wickedness is at an all-time high. I don't know why people are laughing and living it up at in a time of spiritual warfare. You know, we're living in the end times right now. So it doesn't make sense to be living it up. Let's see, I'm going to jump down to verse 8, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. All right, we're not in the time of peace. You know, there's wars and rumors of wars going around right now. You know, the Syrian, if you just try to look up the Syrian conflict, you know, you're not gonna find a clear answer. It's just a huge mess, and it's not coming to a stop. It's just going to intensify. If you look at the North Korean conflict, you know, it doesn't seem like it's going to stop anytime soon. You know, we're in a proxy war in Syria with Russia. North Korea isn't going to back down with their nukes. I think Russia has been accused of poisoning a UK diplomat. So there's tensions between UN and Russia. Trump has mentioned a space force, and also Trump wants to have a military parade on the 4th of July. So I mean, does it sound like we're in a time of peace right now? Or does it sound like we're in a time for war? All right, verse 9, what profit hath he that worketh in that wherein he laboreth? I have seen the travail which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. Yeah, what, I mean, all your working isn't gonna profit you anything. All right. Let's see. I'm gonna jump to Isaiah, chapter 65, verse 11. But ye are they that forsake the Lord, that forget my holy mountain, that prepare a table for that troop, and the furnish of the drink offering unto that number. Therefore will I number you to the sword, and ye shall all bow down to the slaughter. Because when I called, ye did not answer. When I spake, ye did not hear, but did evil before mine eyes, and did choose that when I delighted not. All right. So the Lord right now is he's reaching out his hand. All right. He's offering repentance. And just like in the time of Noah, he said, "Look, there's a flood coming." Right now, we're saying death and destruction is coming. Repent, for the kingdom is at hand. All right. And y'all didn't want to listen. So he's going to hand y'all over to the slaughter. I'm going to read verse 12 again. Therefore will I number you to the sword, and ye shall all bow down to the slaughter. Because when I called, ye did not answer. When I spake, ye did not hear, but did evil before mine eyes, and did choose that wherein I delighted not. Alright, so y'all basically spit in the Lord's face. Just because it wasn't, obvious, it wasn't him himself coming down to you saying, quit doing this. He works through men, all right? He reveals his secrets to the prophets, and the prophets go out and speak. And just because you didn't want to listen to us, y'all are going to have to die, all right? Verse 13, therefore, thus saith the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, God, the power, all right? Behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. All right? So y'all are living it up right now. Y'all are drinking right now and having a good old time. But he says, no, you're going to go hungry. You're going to suffer for the famines. You're gonna go thirsty, but my servants, they're gonna have a nice time, right? When all this destruction is happening, y'all are gonna get fucked up. My servants are gonna be set, all right? That's what the Lord's saying. Yeah, behold, my servants shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. You're gonna be shamefaced when you see all these things come to pass. Imagine those people back in the days of Noah when it started raining up to their necks, and they were like, oh crap, it's not stopping. I can't swim forever. They're ashamed. They said, man, I should have freaking listened to that dude that was building that boat. All right? That's how y'all are going to be when you see these nukes come off, when you see your government turn against you, when you see your own neighbors turn against you. Y'all are going to be shamefaced. Verse 14, behold, my servant shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart, and shall howl for vexation of spirit. Yeah, because once calamities start to happen, then you're going to be vexed in the spirit. But really, the righteous men are vexed right now, seeing all these abominations going on. Let's see. I'm gonna read Proverbs. Let's see, 1 and 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge? All right. Yeah, fools hate knowledge, man. The knowledge of this scripture, man. When these prophets are breaking down, look, nukes are coming. You know, whatever carnal thing that you have isn't gonna save you. All right. That's the real knowledge. All right, knowing that, knowing the breakdowns of these scriptures, y'all hate it. How long will you love simplicity? Because a simple person loves, or how long will you a simple one loves simplicity? You know, simplicity is working 5 days a week, and then living it up on spending a paycheck on the weekend, all right, or saving up money for spring break. Going out and partying, man. That's simple, man. That's monotony. You're going through the motions. We were made to freaking make discoveries, alright? Because that's what Jake does. He's the one that invents and discovers, alright? We're supposed to be the ones exploring the depths of the sea, not Esau. The depths of space, not Esau, alright? Verse 23, turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. Because I have called and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. Alright? You know, that's, once again, the Lord's opening up his arms, but you don't want to come back to his arms. That ye have set at naught all my counsel, and would none of my reproof. I will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. Hey, and he's going to do that through his prophets. You know? Because we've been here trying to tell you, trying to warn you. And then once it happens, he's going to laugh at you, man. You know, you're going to be ashamed. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. Hey, man, that's going into the famine of the word, because we're not going to be out on the highways and byways for much longer, right? You know, when martial law kicks off, and net neutrality repeal happens, come into play. You know, you're not gonna see all these videos up on the internet. But yeah, once you start suffering, that's when you're gonna try to get right with the Lord. But it's not gonna happen. He's not gonna hear you. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would none of my counsel, they despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whoso hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely and shall be quiet from fear of evil. So if you repent, you're set. If you start putting your trust in the Lord, you're set. But now's not the time to be partying and bullshitting, all right? Now's not the time to be, you know, trying to make your March Madness brackets. So that shit's rigged anyways, all right? If you can't see that March Madness is rigged, Lonzo Ball, about a few weeks ago, he said, yeah, man, everybody in the NCAA is paid. You know, you can go watch Blue Mountain State on Netflix. You know, it's about a college football team. Hey man, it's funny. I think the, well, I mean, y'all brothers just watch it. But there's this one episode where basically it shows, you know, like all the good players have their own agents. You know, they're set. They get paid, man. They get paid by agents. The college football teams have agents, all right, to make sure. Like I have friends that when they go, like they're pretty good at ball, man. And then when they go visiting these colleges, they and they really want to recruit them for their team. And they, when they're on that visit, they make sure that they get everything they want. You know, girls, food, drinks, everything they want, to make them nice and comfortable, to make sure that they go to school there, right? Like this one dude, he was telling me, like he was in like a nice hotel that they paid for when he was visiting, or it was the dorm room, I should say. It was like an apartment or whatever, and they asked him like what he wanted to eat, and he was like, yeah, I can just go for a cheeseburger and some fries and a Coke. And they brought him like 5 cheeseburgers and like 10 things of fries and like four large Cokes, you know, just to overdo it, to make them, you know, comfortable. Hey man, but you know, that shit's rigged. Now's not the time to be making those March Madness brackets, all right? Or you know, going out and celebrating St. Patrick's Day. You know, now's not the time to be, you know, living it up, so to speak. You know, get right with the Lord, all right? He's about to come soon, all right? So I hope this video was edifying, and that I'm going to say shalom.